This has been the U.S. Bank NBC Sports Report. U.S. Bank, all of us serving you.
This is Bridget Sloan of Pittsboro, Indiana. Recently, she became the U.S. National All-Around Champion, and now she finds herself as one of the veteran anchors in the World Championships held here at the O2 Arena inside the Millennium Dome on the River Thames, which is exactly where the world will be for the Olympics in 2012. NBC Sports presents the 2009 World Gymnastics Championships, presented by AT&T. It is the second and final day in the women's all-around, and we will begin on the vault, the first of four events. And it is impossible, really, to consider that the same gym that brought us Carly Patterson and Nastia Lukin brings us Rebecca Bross from Plano, Texas. Al Troutwig along with Tim Daggett and Elfie Schlegel. How would you describe her story to get to this World Championships, Tim?
Well, she is a powerhouse. There's no question about it. She has so much going for her in so many different areas.
U.S. all-around gold medalists, it's a short list. Breton, Smeskel, Miller, Memel, Patterson, Johnson, Lukin. Can we see the list add one more today?
And the Americans haven't missed a beat in all those results. And you're looking at these two young ladies, Bridget Sloan, Rebecca Bross. Really, it's going to come down to one of them. They've looked powerful throughout the podium trainings, the first competition. This is where the buzz is, these two American women.
Yeah, I don't think anybody else can beat them, frankly. Just the way everything's looked. You have Rebecca Bross. She is so dynamic, so powerful. She does lack international experience at this level, so you never know what's going to happen. And then, of course, Bridget Sloan. She's been here before. She was part of the Olympic team that came home with the silver in Beijing, China.
She looks like she wants to punch you in the face. That's about as serious as we have ever seen her look.
She's in the zone. You know, I think it's something, really. I don't know if there's ever been a World Championships where it looked so cut and dry. They know, both of them know, that if they do their job, it's possible.
The first gymnast that we'll see is from Australia, Lauren Mitchell.
And Lauren was part of the Olympic team that was represented back in Beijing. Her team came sixth in the all-around competition. She said she has improved so much, especially on this event. She's worked very, very hard to upgrade.
Really nice. Yurchenko with a double twist, as Elfie said, an improvement for her. She has looked fantastic in this competition. She's already qualified, in addition to the all-around finals, to two different event finals. It's a huge, huge jump for Australian gymnastics. Just a little bit of form in the air and a step. And you notice that line that's in the middle right there, because both feet land to the side of that red line, she'll incur an extra tenth of a point off in the air, and she'll also be deducted for that that step, which will be about three tenths of a point.
And Lauren Mitchell receives a 14.4 in the new scoring world of gymnastics. Well, you really have to wonder what this gymnastics world is going to look like 1 year after an Olympics. It's a shakeout year.
Well, she will definitely factor in, and her gymnastics can be summed up by attack.
Fantastic. Oh, she almost had that. She looked like a dart landing on that mat. Maybe just needed to stay down a little bit, but there, of course, with her famous coach, Valeri Lukin. But she explodes. Much better form than we just saw, and ever so close.
And Tim, of course, we're seeing so many of this type of vault in the women's all-around competition. So what will set them apart, the best ones, will be the ones that are more powerful, higher, but you have to try to stick. That will make the difference, the stick.
And Rebecca starts things off with a 14.525. so much gymnastics still to come to figure out where that fits in. Yang Yilin from China.
Of course, the bronze medalist behind Nastia Lukin and Sean Johnson in the all-around championships. And she's got a gold medal for the team champions.
And
the
this,
Chinese
of course,
were so dominant in Beijing.
And on uneven bars, dominant here. This, of course, one of her best exercises. She hasn't changed much since Beijing.
She has battled a number of injuries. And really, this is her first major meet back.
Looking a little tired.
She does look tired, yeah. You see that arch of her body, and she barely got her hands on the bar right there.
These are long, long routines.
Oh, she's, wow.
Yeah, she just ran out of steam.
Yeah, that is purely, she is not in the shape that she needs to be to get this around after that long exercise, and that's not even close to making it. She'll lose a full point off. You see that 7.45 execution score. She just got hammered.
But it seems as though she's physically okay, but a score less than 14, not what you want. Here's Katerina Kurbatova from Russia.
Very powerful vaulter as well.
That was nice.
Nice job.
A big, big hop.
And you know, she got the call because one of her teammates, Ksenia Afanaseva, got injured right while she was here in London. She wasn't even supposed to compete in these worlds. But nice power, just a little sloppy in the legs.
Yeah, the major deduction is right there on the landing. Quite a significant hop.
But you know, guys, gymnastics is so complicated now that it seems as though no one ever sticks to the landing.
Well, you know, it is complicated, and it's very, very difficult on the apparatus. The routines are so long, they're exhausted. It's almost like an afterthought.
And they want to bring back artistry to the sport, but it almost defeats the purpose.
Kurbatova gets a 14.625. And what's going on with fashion? The Russians don't wear red anymore, and the Americans don't wear red, white, and blue. Still to come, Bridget Sloan. The 2009 World Gymnastics Championships from London, England are being brought to you by AT&T, your world delivered. And by Subway Restaurants. Try the new low-fat buffalo chicken sub. So the World Championships continue here in London at the O2 Arena. This is Koko Tsurumi of Japan.
Placed 17th all-around at the Olympic Games in China. But she has a wonderful line, and she is terrific on the uneven bars. Beautiful handstand positions, lots of difficulty. Here we go, first release. Nicely done.
Yeah, Tim, she's certainly one of the greatest talents that has come out of Japan in such a long, long time.
Excellent body position. Beautiful routine, wow. You know, when you think about Japanese gymnastics, you think of the men. But that young lady right there, that was a terrific start, a great start.
And she has some Russian influence. She has a Russian coach that has been there for the past 4 years.
Over to the vault, and our first look at Bridget Sloan in competition.
So we've seen this vault that she's going to do a couple of times. She's going to be cleaner and, I think, more powerful than both of them.
Yeah, she is. It's just those dreaded hops at the end.
Huge, huge power on that vault. And like I said, getting a few words from her coach, Marvin Sharp.
But it had one of the best body lines, and it had some nice power off the horse. Fairly straight.
A little bit cleaner.
She's off to the right.
Yeah, she's off to the right. Now, if they land with one foot in the red, it would be a more significant deduction. But she'll get, it's just a tenth of a point. And that step, I'd call that only a tenth of a point as well.
But still, when you stick these vaults, the overall impression that that leaves the judges sitting down below, it could raise it quite a bit more.
No question.
14.825 for Bridget Sloan. And so far in this competition, that's pretty good. We go over to the uneven bars. Yona Dufournay of France.
We saw her at the American Cup much earlier this year, and it was her first meet as a senior gymnast.
And she has improved significantly.
Yeah, she has, because she was a little scary there, to be honest. It has come a long way. She's a nice-looking gymnast.
A lot of little areas where the judges are going to take those deductions. Her handstands weren't perfectly in the vertical. There was some sloppiness throughout the routine, but that comes with experience. Being on this international stage can only get better.
Beautiful dismount, though. Exactly the way the judges want it. Nice, straight body. Well, once again, as we said, the hop on the landing.
Frenay's score of 14.6. Boy, you really get the feeling with the level of gymnastics that we're seeing so far. A year after the Olympic Games, there's a lot of different things that are possible here for a lot of different gymnasts.
No question. Like you said, the year after the Olympics, and you see the score right there, 15.05 for Coco. It's really a shaking out period, and sometimes you see even world champions that often you never see again.
Kasnina Semenova of Russia.
She was fourth in the all-around last year in Beijing.
And actually, she is the reigning world champion on this event right here, the uneven bars. Beautiful combination.
She was always known as a bar and beam specialist, but very quickly became an all-around gymnast for this Russian team.
Another release right here. Very famous for that one. And that is disastrous. Right there, her transition from the high to the low bar.
And falls today are worth one full point. That's harsh.
Yeah, she just didn't meet the bar at all with her hands. She let the bar come to her. You know, I had heard that she really wasn't in the best of condition. That was much better. I think that she's just not in good enough shape. And she, at that point, was too tired. Gets a little bit of a breather after the fall, but she will fall.
Ooh.
Watch this dismount, though. Really cool. It doesn't matter how cool it is. If you've fallen from the apparatus, you don't even get anything from her Russian coach right there.
You know, she's grown a bit since Beijing. She's had to readjust. Very difficult to do, especially on uneven bars. She's working with a taller body.
You know, it was a little bit far from the bar as well, but this is truly the highlight. Look at this dismount. Very nicely done. She's known for that worldwide.
But it will cost 13.25, and in this all-around, her world championships might already be over.
And you got to remember, Al, that she is the reigning world champion on the uneven bars. She did so poorly in qualifying, she didn't even make the event finals, and her best event takes her out of the competition.
What does China have in store for us a year after their great Olympic Games? Here's Deng Lilin.
And Deng was part of that Olympic team that won gold, and she's back.
The same vault we have seen. It's kind of compulsory for the top-level athletes.
But she's so little, she can barely get up off the horse. She can barely get any height.
And if you were looking at that screen, you saw that 0.1 for deduction, and that is for step for landing outside of that middle line.
That was a moment ago. Now we're back with the action. Here's Rebecca Downey of Great Britain. And let me tell you, the Brits have great plans for what they want to get out of the Olympics in 2012. And they're starting to show with their results. We'll be right back.
uniform, the flag ablaze right there. If I had to choose a team in the world that has improved the most, men and women, it was Great Britain.
13.525 from a moment ago, Rebecca Downey, but the lead belongs to Koko Tsurumi of Japan. Still to come, Bridget Sloan. The 2009 Gymnastics World Championships continue from the O2 Arena and the Millennium Dome on the River Thames in London, site of the 2012 Olympic Games of Summer. So a lot of the attention is on the national champion from the United States, who has had a tremendous game face on. That's Bridget Sloan, who right now is second place after the first rotation. And the leader after the first rotation is from Japan, Koko Tsurumi. And the Japanese women are not known for getting a little attention here.
That's true. They have not won an all-around medal at a World Championships in 43 years. Whereas the men, they got one yesterday with Kohei Uchimura. He took home the gold. And they have many, many, many champions in their past.
And Koko had actually said after the qualification, I thought this was kind of cute. She said, oh, the men always get all the attention. We don't get any.
So there are the standings after the first of four rotations. Sloan trailing by .225, and Rebecca Bross part of the top 10 list as well. We're going to pick things up with the vault and continue with the Great Britain story. They have the home court advantage. Rebecca Downey felt it. Cheers were huge after her floor exercise. And as you said, Tim, this is the team that really is improving.
Yeah, tremendously. I mean, yesterday they had a man named Daniel Keatings who won the silver medal in the all-around. That is unheard of. It's just unthinkable. And they have other great stars. Beth Tweedle, who we'll see in the individual event finals on floor exercise. They really have come a long way.
But Tim, for Rebecca, even last year in Beijing, this team was so thrilled to make it into the top 12 just to qualify to the Olympic Games. They ended up as a team in ninth. She ended up 12th in the all-around.
Yeah, you know, and I really thought she was going to improve vastly. She doesn't look as fit as I've seen her in the past.
But this is a good event for her.
Yep.
Very powerful. She has started the competition with her first two strong events.
Well, they love their Brits, that's for sure.
Well, we've seen it before. With Olympic commitment comes money. With money comes facilities. With facility comes coaches. With coaches comes effort. And with effort, coaches, money, and facilities comes results.
Yep, comes medals.
You see that number on the left-hand part of your screen, 5.8. That indicates the value of this vault. The maximum she can score is a 15.8 if she got a perfect 10 in the execution.
You know, she is ecstatic to be competing in the O2 Arena in her hometown. I don't think that she's at the level to challenge for a medal at this championships. But the way they have been growing their program, you just got to look out for all of Great Britain. Actually, they had their first Olympic medal in many, many years, Lewis Smith. Won an Olympic bronze medal on the pommel horse. We'll see him in the individual event finals.
Sometimes the scores just seem to take a little bit longer.
She said that she looked back at her meet that she had in Beijing, China, and she said, I can do better. I gotta do more.
14.5 is the final tally. And now Yang Yilin of China on the balance beam.
This will be interesting. Remember, she completely ran out of gas.
But this is an apparatus where she has excelled, known for her great lines on balance beam. You'll get a variety of ways of mounting the beam. She's chosen just to simply step up, but she has a lot of difficulty starting with that jump right there.
Bit of a balance check.
So we're going to see a lot of combinations like right there, but balance checks back and forth. And if you don't connect them all, the judges will absolutely not give you the connection bonus. They have been very tough scoring this event.
And you know, the women in 2008 at the Olympic Games, the Chinese, they were unbelievable. And she does not have that look at all. There's another error. She looks like she's doubting herself. She looks like she's not physically prepared.
So like right there, that skill was supposed to connect much quicker with this skill here. So all of these add up. There have been many misconnections and wobbles.
Yeah, and with those wobbles and with that crash on her dismount from the uneven bars, I would say that she has already taken herself out of the competition. That cat call means she has 10 seconds to dismount the beam.
But what's interesting is, unlike the men, the women did send all-arounders to this competition. I find that very interesting.
Yeah, I do too, because they, both of them, did not appear to be ready to do the all-around.
We will get her score. Didn't seem like it would be anything near great. We go to the uneven bars, and Romania's Anna Porgras. And after all their glory years and glory Olympics and glorious world championships, where is Romanian gymnastics now?
Well, you know what? I think it sits right in her hands right here. The national team coach, Nicolae Formenti, he says that this girl is wonderful. Just look at her. She's special in everything that she does. She's talented. She's light. She's flashy. She's only 15 years old. He cannot stop bragging about this young lady.
As he should, but traditionally, Romanians have struggled on this apparatus. They've always excelled on balance beam, floor exercise, and vault, but uneven bars, just something about that team, they've never been able to put it together. Now, she can swing, but she still has a ways to go.
She does, but I would say that, and that angle right there, everything is supposed to finish in a handstand. That'll be at least 3/10 of a point, possibly even 5.
But she certainly is the bright light for this team. She's going places. She has a nice look.
She is trying to go where her nation has been before.
Yes, so many great champions.
Look at the team success. You look at the all-around medal successes.
But in the last two Olympic Games, 04 and 08, they were shut out when they had been so dominant in the past in the all-around.
But they did manage to get the medals. They seem to always claw their way back onto that podium.
Yeah, and I really think if they do, it'll be a lot to do with Anna Porgras.
Meanwhile, we go to the uneven bars now, and Rebecca Bross. Bross from Plano, Texas. It's really unbelievable when you think about it. I mean, it's like having a young kid called up to Yankee Stadium and, you know, having experienced greatness and then absorbing just a little bit of it into their own blood.
But you got to remember, though, for Bross, the last two Olympic champions came from her gym. I said, do you ever think about that? Do you ever daydream? And she says, no, but sometimes I do dream about it.
Yeah, as she should. She is powerful here, and she attacks this apparatus like no one else.
Got a huge release skill, not that one, coming up. I love the way she does. It's called a Jaeger front flip right here. Huge, and fingertips. Awesome.
I mean, she's just unstoppable. There's a whole lot of confidence to this routine.
And you know, the great thing about her is sometimes athletes get injuries and it slows them down tremendously. She has been hurt. She used to be the one that was weak on bars.
And that's how you land a dismount.
It is. She used to be weak on bars. When she was injured, she spent a tremendous amount of time, as she gets a hug from Coach Valeri. But she spent that time, and now I think it's one of her best events.
The only area are the knees. And of course, you can really see it in the slow-mo, but throughout the routine, especially on this event, the judges want to see legs locked together.
And gymnastics 101. What is it, Al?
Stick it.
Finally, someone stuck a landing.
Two American women, as they've been for much of these world championships, side by side. One will have to try and distance one from the other, but a very good 15.075 for Rebecca Ross of Plano, Texas. Meanwhile, we can tell you that Yang Yi Lin got a 14.225 on her performance a few moments ago on the beam. Now the leader after the first rotation, Coco Tsurumi.
And this will be a lovely exercise, and this is where you're going to see some of that Russian influence in her dance work. Her coach has been in Japan for the past 4 years, came from Russia. She has a beautiful style.
Very steady. I'm sure she wishes she would have another shot. She made the finals in China on balance beam and really had a hard time. Finishing 8 out of 8. You see when she tips her head back, that's a very popular skill that doesn't look all that difficult, but is incredibly difficult.
I like this skill coming up right here. These are some of these skills that are memorable skills. I look at something like that and I'm thinking, way to go, Coco, because you're taking something and making it your own. And it looks just a little bit different from the cookie-cutter gymnastics that sometimes gets abused.
There you go. Beautiful gymnastics and hardly a wobble so far.
Just the dismount. Yeah, nice gymnastics, lovely.
Look out, she has come to play. She's going to be right in there.
Trying to hang on to the lead here in these world championships. We will get to her score in a moment. Meanwhile, just a moment ago, Yona de Fournay of France on the balance beam. She was fourth after the first rotation, so she's knocking on the door a bit.
These are some of these combinations right here. This one of the more popular combinations that you'll see on balance beam.
See, they actually get bonus tenths when they combine skills together. That series got her an extra 2 tenths. And that right there, an Arabian front, exceedingly difficult.
Just lacking a little bit of flexibility in that skill. So these are some of the areas right here. I mean, she has all the big skills. She's popping them out, but you have to pay attention to the artistry because that is what the judges are saying. They're really going to concentrate on. Beautiful double turn. That was a huge risk element.
And the way they're encouraging that artistry, they used to have to do 10 elements that were counted for their final score. Now they only do 8. And on balance beam and floor exercise, 3 of them have to be of the leap dance category.
She did a good job. A lot of areas to work on, the dance, but she certainly has the skill level.
She does. She really, really needs to improve her flexibility, though. It's a requirement that you show a 180 split on one of those leaps, and she definitely can't get there.
Tsurumi's 14.8. We'll know soon if she's able to hold on to the lead. Dufresne's score, much less than that, a 14.45, and still to come from the United States. Bridget Sloan, she will be next in these world championships, hoping to be very even on the uneven bars. We're in London after this. The World Gymnastics Championships presented by AT&T on NBC Sports. This is Ekaterina Kurbatova about to perform on the uneven bars. She's in third place after the first of 4 rotations.
Third place, and she wasn't even supposed to be here.
That's right. And you know, Russia has really been doing a lot to reemerge as a powerhouse. They have been very few times on the podium for Russia as of late. They brought back one of their great coaches, Alexander Alexandrov. He was in the United States coaching for many years. He is now back at the helm of women's gymnastics. And
they say they have a great group of juniors.
Yeah, this was just okay. You know, it's certainly doesn't knock your socks off, but that's what everybody's talking about, is the level of gymnastics from their juniors is so much superior, and just wait for them to become age eligible. Remember, you have to be at least 16 years old to compete in an international competition.
I think they're just buying a little bit of time, and gymnasts like Ekaterina, she's here right now, but I have a hard time believing that she would actually make a 2012 Olympic team for Russia.
No, I agree with you.
Bridget Sloan getting set, second place after the first rotation. How's the uneven bars for her, Tim?
It's great. Actually, uneven bars was one of the reasons she was chosen to make the 2018 for the USA.
She said it was her highlight after the qualification round, because she had started on balance beam, had a fall, but this was the highlight in the qualifying round, and she said she was really anxious to get back today to show everybody what she really can do.
Remember, you gotta hit those handstands. Right there. And this one. She'll actually do...
I like this one.
A much more difficult... Right here,
she's
with her legs together, extremely difficult and very rare.
She is swinging bars better than I've ever seen her work bars before. A little separation there on the bottom bar, but she has a nice tightness about her too.
She's got her big dismount back in. She'll do an extra full twist on her double rail. Just the smallest of steps, but a great job. Marvin always coaching away. There was that error. The legs came apart just a bit.
And remember, those judges are sitting down on the floor right alongside the bars, so they're not missing anything. They can see when those legs separate at all times.
Look at her dismount. The thing that's different, we've seen a lot of double layouts, but right there you see she's twisting on that first flip. Makes it much more difficult.
We get a smile out of Bridget Sloan.
Well, so far, Team USA is getting the job done. They are 4 for 4.
And a 14.8.
Good score.
Back to the Chinese story, and Deng Linlin, seventh after the first rotation. I can tell you that the Chinese women, once again, have had their ages reaffirmed through the paperwork after the controversy in Beijing.
But not from Sydney. Actually, there are two athletes that are still under investigation, and the FIG says if they're found to be too young, they'll take their medals away.
And Deng, just like her teammate, she has all the very difficult skills that we're used to seeing from Chinese athletes on this event, but it's really tough for her to get from high bar to low bar. Watch her transitions. She's so tiny, she struggles sometimes just to get up there. Doesn't show always the same stretch or swing.
Another full twisting double layout.
Same as Bridget Sloan's.
Little bit of a closed body. What I mean by that is when the hips bend, they're either going to have to devalue that or take a deduction, because she did not remain straight as Bridget did.
So guys, here at halftime, what about these American women?
Yeah, they look...
As expected.
Yeah, they look as expected and almost unstoppable. And she looks unaffected, which is very impressive.
Back to Lauren Mitchell of Australia.
This was an event that Lauren has struggled with, like the vault, this has not been an easy event for her. She said after Beijing, she went back and worked extra hard to try to upgrade her difficulty, but it's oftentimes not enough just to get the skills, it's how you're performing it. Remember, there are two scores, what you're doing and how well you're performing it.
And although she's gotten better, everything looks a little bit labored. Dismount right here.
Yeah, that was hard for her.
Big hop at the end. I can tell you that Deng Lin Lin got a 13.9 on the uneven bars. Big crowd here in London at the O2 Arena.
And all these skills, like stretching the body out, the handstand positions, those are all areas where Lauren can really improve upon. It's that execution score. She needs improvement.
She gets a 13.625. We will check the scoreboard here at these World Championships next. Coverage begins at 7 Eastern, only on NBC. The World Championships continue in London, and Bridget Sloan is exactly where she was after the first rotation, unable to make up any ground, but still she's been very consistent, and wow, the look on her face is everything about being competitive here. The difference, 0.225, and then Rebecca Bross of the United States is right behind Bridget Sloan. Then there's a little bit of a gap beyond that, so Americans looking good for the podium. Koko Tsurumi of Japan is the leader. We move to the floor exercise. And next up from Japan will be Koko Tsurumi. Trying to be a little bit of a Japanese trailblazer here. Or if it was a mistake.
Well, she didn't have tumbling that is going to make you sit on the edge of your seat. I thought her choreography actually was very well done to the music. And what the code is saying in this cycle of gymnastics is, whatever you do, just make sure you do it well. And I thought she did.
Rebecca Bross is on the balance beam. Love that mount.
She just ran right up on the beam. Just attacked.
Yeah, that's exactly what she does. She has only one speed, and it's all out.
And in the qualification day, this was the one apparatus where she had faltered, and that was at the very end on her dismount. She just has this mindset. She's not afraid, and she's very sure.
And that dismount, very difficult. The same dismount that Carly Patterson basically invented, which helped her to win her all-around gold medal.
And you know what's interesting?
In 2004.
She had difficulty with that dismount, Tim, at the national championships and in the qualification. But from what I can tell, she's still planning to do it. So
she's
not afraid.
To see. Yeah.
She's not afraid to go for it.
very just like purposeful. Everything just go.
And telling all the other gymnasts, just get out of my way. Here I come. And
so
here's the
here we go. The big one. Yep.
Wow.
Awesome.
I am so impressed that she stuck with the plan.
Jeez.
She's finding a way to make that dismount work. Because it's big time.
You get a big smile like that from Valeri, and you know it was something. This is gonna get a huge score.
Very risky element. The standing Arabian loses sight of the beam. It's a blind landing, and it's very, very difficult, but this was wow.
Yeah, half turn to a double front. Extremely well done. Boy, that's going to do a lot in her all-around ranking right there.
Finally, look at that execution score, 9.1. I don't think we've seen one over 9 yet.
So a 15.3 as she looks to improve on her third place standing. And they can't wait to get this to the next routine.
It's like, slow down, you've got floor exercise still.
I haven't quite seen that before.
She may have to get some tape on an ankle or something like that.
Meanwhile, Tsurumi gets a 13.725. And for both Americans, a door may be opening. Bridget Sloan is up next. These are the Gymnastics World Championships presented by AT&T on NBC Sports.
Hey everybody, I'm Alicia Sacamone and this is AT&T Fanfare. I'm going to show some fans some video clips on my mobile phone from AT&T. I have a tumbling pass on beam and one on floor to see if fans can name that tumbling pass.
Hey everyone, I'm here with
Hannah Hinky,
and I'm going to see if Hannah can name that tumbling pass.
Backhandspring double pipe.
Nice.
Can I watch it again?
Yeah, watch
okay.
it again.
Backhandspring double pipe.
Samantha Peschick, my teammate from the 2008 Olympics. What is she doing right there?
Front handspring, front full, front double.
Yeah, you got it. If you didn't get that, I would probably have to disown you as a friend.
I am a gymnast.
Woo! Full twisting, front flip, with the double full.
Yeah.
All right.
Front handspring, full finish, double full.
Yeah, good job. That's going to do it for another edition of AT&T Fanfare. AT&T is a proud sponsor of USA Gymnastics.
Actually says she is going to make a comeback in gymnastics, hopes to be at the 2010 U.S. National Championships.
This is Ekaterina Kurbatova. She's in fourth after two rotations.
Really struggled on uneven bars.
And that right there, a full point off. Just takes that fourth place and sends it packing, that's for sure.
It's pretty drastic, and that's what they're saying with this new cycle of gymnastics. If you're going to do a skill, you have to make sure you're doing it very, very well. And those that are doing the very risky skills, you better be sure, because if not, a full point, that can just shoot you right down in the standings.
Well, remember, Rebecca Barras just rocked a balance beam routine, and with that, she didn't just broad jump, but she long jumped ahead of Coco Tsurumi in the standings so far. Well, even without the fall, that would not be a routine that would bring in a huge number, but
yeah,
very
Russian,
disappointing.
And this Russian team is really, think about all those world championships we have been to where we couldn't wait to see the next Russian
what would
star.
Be next? Yeah.
And I remember always waiting to see who that new kid was going to be, and they are definitely in a rebuilding stage.
Judges kill it. They give it a 12.85, and you could argue that this is the most important 90 seconds in the career of Bridget Sloan.
Actually had a fall in the qualification round. She started on balance beam and was very nervous.
Some of these jumps are actually, believe it or not, they're more difficult than the acrobatic elements. She looks very calm right now. Little too much of a pause in between that combination, and then you saw the balance check.
Again, yeah, that one a little bit more severe. Yeah, there's just no mercy from the judges when it comes to things like that.
Yeah, I don't really think she's off so far, though. I think that it's just confidence. She's not...
Very nice.
Ah. Once again.
It's the arms.
She looks perfectly on balance. She just looks like she's doubting herself a bit. And another. Jeez.
Yeah, they all add up, don't they? Just a dismount. 10 seconds. She was on, but very tentative.
Yeah.
Not quite the aggressive style.
Yeah, it was close between Ross and Sloan, but I would say that with this effort from Bridget, she's going to be playing catch-up on her last event. Whenever you show a lack of balance in any way, you will be deducted. Beautiful dismount lands. You know, very nicely, just the smallest little step.
She doesn't know which way to look.
That is why they call it the balance beam.
Just a few too many unsure moments.
And a lot of...
Even. She's going to gain ground in comparison to first place. And we come down to Deng Linlin of China, eighth after the second rotation.
She does everything in this balance beam. Just got this checklist of difficult skills, and I don't know how she packs as much as she does into this routine, into the time allotted, but she does.
Oh, and that is...
That's a fall.
That's a fall. 5/10 of a point for grabbing that balance beam.
Very difficult jump element to switch ring leap. She loses sight of the beam. Taking a lot of risks. You sometimes wonder some of those skills if it's really worth it, because now that's a fall. And that's a full point.
Wow. She is much better than this on balance beam.
Just not her day.
Easily qualified for the event finals. Once again, the Chinese women, they just don't have
that
same look that they had in Beijing at all.
I think, Tim, she's going to be overtime. That bell went,
And she is.
Yeah, that's overtime. Oh, she just tried to cram a lot of gymnastics in there with all the wobbles and falls. It wasn't her day. That was too bad.
For all the gymnastics we've done together, I've never seen anyone beat the clock or get beaten by the clock on the beam.
Well, she gets rattled, you know? That's a fall, 5/10 deduction, and another one. Not good.
Score 13.50, and it certainly felt like it might have been worse than that. Back in London at the World Championships presented by AT&T. We're still in the third rotation, but Rebecca Bross's head is in the fourth and final rotation. She is in front right now and has to be thinking that something great is possible.
I think she's going to go into the last rotation with about a point lead on everybody else.
Yeah, should be
with her closest competitor, at least.
Should be hers to win.
Seventh after two rotations, Gang Yilin of China.
For the Olympic all-around bronze medalist, it certainly has not been a great all-around championship here in London.
big change in women's gymnastics is all of their tumbling passes are supposed to come to a complete still, like the men, which is very new.
And that's a deduction. So hops or steps. It's very difficult for these women to do that.
Tim, I just do not understand why they want to make the sport so hard and so complex that at this particular level, they want the gymnasts to all look like they're making mistakes.
Yeah, it's a mistake in every way. It's actually makes them look more robotic, and they lose a little bit of the artistry because of it. I don't know why they did it, and many are opposed.
The Chinese have really improved, however, is in the artistry, in choreography. They have used a French rhythmic gymnast for many years now to help in that department, and I think it has paid off.
Now we go to the beam and Lauren Mitchell of Australia.
Doing a very nice job today.
And this is her forte. She's great on this event.
A little bit of a wobble there. She'll be vying for an individual event medal in a couple of days on balance beam.
What Lauren has tried to do in this exercise is take some skills to make
Watch
them her
this.
Own.
This is so cool.
Double turn, and that is not easy.
I bet
not
that's
easy.
By far her most difficult and risky element.
Absolutely.
Not most difficult, but most risky element in the entire exercise.
The risk paid off, and that is very cool. Now, there's a combination that makes me sit up and say, wow, okay, finally someone's doing something
different.
A little different.
Yeah.
Thank you. She has some really great combinations. She's put a lot of thought into this routine to make it stand out. They'll score well.
Yeah, she is having a competition, I'll tell you.
Question is, will it improve her ninth standing rotations?
I would say definitely.
Back to Paul Grass of Romania.
She's the 2008 European champion on this event, and of course, Romania, as long as I can remember, since watching Nadia in 1976 in Montreal, they've always been great on balance beam.
And you know what has really made them so great is the ability for them to stay on, whereas other athletes, other countries seem to always struggle with the consistency. The Romanians on balance beam, it is a rare sight to see them come off the balance beam.
The Mitchell score is taking a long time. Yang Yi Lin's floor score was a 13.70.
It's a lot of scribble on there.
Yeah, each individual skill that they do has a symbol so that they can go back and recite the routine. It's got a symbol and a deduction and what each skill is worth.
Looked like the only thing missing from that judge's table was an abacus.
Now, she has a lot of artistry to her gymnastics, and that's one of the things that has made her so popular.
Beautiful lines, and as we mentioned before, some struggle with flexibility, not her. Beautiful.
Meanwhile, Lauren Mitchell got a 15.1. That's a home run.
Yeah, she doesn't struggle with flexibility. Very different combination, starting with a back walkover.
That is a shame. She would have been right in there.
She found herself in the second position in the qualification round. All the buzz was about this new Romanian star.
Yeah, I think she will be a star, but, you know, I just go on about talking how the Romanians never come off balance beam, but it is a different world, and at one time, the Romanians were completely dominant of the sport, and they have really leveled off quite a bit.
But Tim, remember, first world championships. She is just 15 years old, won't turn 16 till the end of the year. Huge experience.
But Tim, am I wrong? I mean, back in the day, the world champion would rock all four events.
Yeah, no question.
Now it's survive four events.
You're right. You're exactly right.
Someone else has been kicked off the island.
And ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let's give them a
look. So
she's a good one, though. We're gonna see her in the future, no question.
She did that unusual combination, starting from a back walkover, which is one of the first skills you learn in the sport. But that fall, of course, one full point.
So she gets a 14.125. Everybody heads to the final rotation. Rebecca Bross is going to be the leader, and Bridget Sloan is right there with her. Tomorrow, more gymnastics from London at 2 p.m. Eastern Time. It's the event finals from the Gymnastics World Championships presented by AT&T. And now the final rotation in the all-around final. And for Rebecca Bross, the question is, can it be yet another champion from Plano, Texas? It is her lead with only one event to go. And this time, it's not the nerve-wracking environment that is the balance beam. It's floor exercise. That's okay. Valerie Lucan, her coach, sees her lead at 1.275. And Tim and Elfie, that is a huge cushion for something like floor exercise. And Coco Cerumi has fallen down to third.
Really what it means is she's just got to get through. Only a disaster on the floor is going to take away that all-around crown.
In progress, seventh after three rotations, Ekaterina Kurbatova.
Outstanding day for Ekaterina. Remember, this is a Russian team in transition. And remember, she was a last-minute replacement to these world championships.
Exactly. She is not going to factor into the medal, no question.
Yuna Dufresne of France on the vault. We'll get Kurbatova's score in a moment.
Great event to finish on. Just one burst of energy right here.
She was in sixth after three rotations. She could be moving up.
And the value of that vault is a 5.6. Remember, the maximum she can get is a 15.6.
It's very nicely done. Keeps a pretty nice body position in the air. The only thing, those toes. Point those toes.
Yeah, and just the landing, not securing herself on that landing. I couldn't quite tell if she was going to almost have a stick. She kind of bounced right out of there.
And so that red line, remember, if both feet land to the side of it, she'll incur a tenth of a point deduction. It was very close.
All the balls now. Canada. Brittany.
Breath of relief. It's over.
Now she gets that deduction, too.
14.3. Execution 8.8. Kurbatova, face tells it all. 13.3, execution 8.2. And now we come down to serious business for Bridget Sloan and Rebecca Bross. Bridget Sloan, second after three rotations, a world championship medal would be so sweet. And it's sitting right there.
Yeah, but she's got to put a little pressure on her teammate. And I think she can do it. She can put that pressure there because at the national championships, I thought that of all the gymnasts, she really had mastered the ability to land and stick without that extra step back. And, you know, if you got four tumbling passes and you take a big step on every one, that's 1.2 in deductions right there.
Of a Carly Patterson and a Sean Johnson, but she's right there now.
And I think that's at least a silver medal, believe it or not, because she came in to this round in second behind Rebecca, and she had a full point over Tsurumi, and this was a great routine.
I mean, there were some spots in some of these tumbling passes where she could not avoid to take that one step on the landing. You'll see it right at the end.
But this is incredibly difficult.
Very difficult, but right there. So what the judges are saying is you need to stick them. But the last thing that they saw was that double pike, her last tumbling pass, and she nailed it.
So Bridget Sloan makes her world championship statement. She medal. What color is it? Feels like the Americans are in good shape. When we come back to the O2 Arena in London, England, we'll see what Rebecca Bross does with her lead in this final rotation of the World Championships. Welcome back to the World Gymnastics Championships on NBC, presented by AT&T. While crunching the numbers, the storyline pretty much is this. The United States is going to leave London with an all-around gold medal. They could do gold and silver. What's left after that is a battle for bronze. And 11th after three rotations, Ksenia Semenova.
And that is the last piece of gymnastics she'll do at these Worlds. Made no event finals. Very big disappointment, and that vault is not going to help.
Yeah, certainly one of the easier vaults that we're seeing at this level of competition. It's only valued at about 15.3, and the form was really all over the place, not to mention the landing. She was forced to tuck down this vault, just simply didn't have enough height.
She came into this competition, many thought that she was a contender to battle for a medal, but you know, really right from the beginning, she took herself out, and this will do nothing I would imagine it'll lower her in the standings. Not a good ball.
13.4. Meanwhile, fourth after three rotations, and that in an event like this is the worst place to be. Lauren Mitchell of Australia.
And just like balance beam, where she stood out and had some signature moves, Lauren takes that to the floor exercise, especially in her opening tumbling pass, trying to make herself stand out just a little differently from everyone else in the competition.
But she really is in the thick of things. I think it's going to come down to Lauren and Tsurumi from Japan. And wouldn't that be amazing? A bronze medalist from Australia in the World Championships.
Back out.
Very close. Any part of your body touches the red, you'll get that penalty. Same skill we saw on balance beam.
Wouldn't that be a shame if it came down to that out of bounds?
Yeah. But I did not see a flag raised. Camouflage the landings by doing little leaps after each one, and hopefully they'll be recognized and she won't get those landing deductions.
She has a really nice persona when she's performing.
Nice exercise. The Australians do a very good job with music selection, and they pay a lot of attention to the choreography. That was great.
She did a great job, not just there, but all the way through. Gets a kiss from her coach, Nikolai Lapshin.
But that,
look at that,
right?
That was definitely out of bounds. So that will cost her a tenth of a point, and it is tight. For bronze, we've got still Koko Tsurumi from Japan to go. This is a very nice landing, but she will get a deduction for that as well.
Yep, those are no-nos.
And there you see it, that one-tenth of a point. Could that come back and haunt her? Wow.
So Koko Tsurumi knows that a little bit of a door opened there, but she also has some work to do. Rebecca Bras still to go. Here's Anna Pogras of Romania.
Thank you.
lucky to have this young lady on their national team. She just has a beautiful balletic charm.
She does.
I felt like I was at the ballet.
Yeah,
beautiful stage presence.
You know, that fall from the balance beam, she's going to remember that for a long time, because right then, that took her out of the medal hunt.
Coco Sarumi still waiting to go. A lot of tension in her world at these Worlds.
Remember, Japan has not won an individual all-around medal on the women's side for 43 years.
See, Poorgrass' score just a little over 14. Bross and Sloan, American teammates right now. Sloan has made her final statement. Bross will have her chance to clinch a gold medal at the 2009 World Championships. We'll be back for that in London after this. Huge gold medal world championship chance for Rebecca Bross that's coming up in a moment. She has the lead heading into a floor exercise final performance. After that, we'll have a battle for bronze. Coco Tsurumi of Japan, but one of the performers not involved in the all-around that we wanted to show you is here. Maria Kesslin of Switzerland. This is her specialty, and it is vault.
Yeah, she was a finalist at the Olympic Games in Beijing, and you saw quickly the 6.3 will give you a slight indication of how difficult this vault is. One of the highest value vaults that we've seen in the women's all-around competition.
She'll do a handspring front with 1.5 twists in a stretched position. 2009 European champion on this event. Very strong.
When did we see countries not wearing their colors? I mean, here we have Switzerland with pink, red, tan, and white. We have the Russians in purple and orange, and the Americans in pink.
She should be wearing her colors. She was voted the 2008 Swiss Sportswoman of the Year. She's somewhat of a star in Switzerland.
Yeah, big moment for her. In that type of vault, you're supposed to keep the body in a stretched, laid-out position, or the judges could have good reason to take a deduction or devalue the skill.
And they will, but it's still going to get a pretty big score.
Hey, Tim, it's going to be the best vault of the entire World Championships, and it's going to have an ending and a dismount the way we're seeing it. Crazy.
Yep. We'll see her in the event finals.
That'll be tomorrow at 2 Eastern time. So that's Maria Kesslin of Switzerland. And now we get down to some really serious business for our final two gymnasts. Coco Tsurumi of Japan, who's going to make a medal statement of some sort and of some kind that will be only seconds long. And then Rebecca Bross on the floor exercise, who's really got to be feeling some never felt before pressure inside her. Kesslin score of 15.125 here at the O2 Arena in London, England, where the world will reassemble in 2012 for the Olympic Games.
And you know, Coco, she really needs to be pristine clean, because she is in third place, but you got Lauren Mitchell, who just put in a big score on the floor exercise, and her vault is a very low-valued vault. So she's got to do it perfectly. Sure, she's capable of doing something a little harder, but she's going for clean. And it was beautiful in the air, just that hop on the landing.
And you know, really this type of vault, it's so basic at this level of competition, and I'm sure for Coco, the game plan down the road is to at least crank out another full twist in this vault, because this is really quite simple. But yeah, like she's done all day, she's done clean, beautiful gymnastics.
It's going to be close. It's going to be really close between Coco and Lauren Mitchell of Australia. And remember, we talked about it with Lauren on floor, that step out of bounds.
Right.
That was a tenth of a point.
And a 13.6 is going to put her third right now.
And Lauren Mitchell from Australia is a quarter of a tenth behind Tsurumi. Oh,
All Rebecca Bros needs to get is a 12.925.
And she can do that.
She can do that with a fluke, couldn't she?
A little bit of a fluke. A couple of little steps here and there, no problem at all.
Even if she stepped on all her landings.
She just has to avoid that Titanic moment.
Rebecca Bros.
First tumbling run. Very, very difficult. Blind landing to a double front. Very good. Gymnastics. Oh my gosh.
No way.
That was.
Well, how costly was that?
That was that Titanic moment right there. At least a full point off on that one element. She didn't need to do it. She could have done something so much easier. She's just not quite rotated enough on this right here.
Oh, she just, it was right on the landing of the first skill into that. Oh, my goodness.
I mean, really, she could have done a simple last tumbling pass.
She could have ended.
With a double fall.
Yes.
And this was great. That was her second tumbling run. First one, excellent as well, but she did have more than a point, but once again, this is going to be close too.
She is just reliving this moment. What did I do?
All she needed was a pretty average 12.925 to win a world championship all-around gold medal.
And that's easy for her. That is really easy for her.
Bridget Sloan is wondering, wait a minute. Did I just become a world champion?
We've seen Valeri pacing around a gymnastics floor for many, many years. I'm sure he is completely shocked as well.
But you know, we watched him handle adversity with Carly. We watched him handle it with Nastia. And we know how it turned out with them. This could be just one of those things that's just awful to taste right now, but is better for something bigger down the road. Who knows?
Exactly. Nastia Lukin was second at the 2005 World Championships. So,
yeah, he lived that moment.
And that's the way it's going to go. It's going to be the United States gold and silver, but it's going to be gold to Bridget Sloan and silver to Rebecca Bros. And you can see the resignation in her face. You can see how much that would have meant to her.
Oh, that hurts, man. That hurts. And now, and for her, Bridget Sloan, what a moment. And Marvin Sharp, you have a world champion.
What a moment.
And Coco Tsurumi is the bronze medalist, and it's a little too much right now for Bridget Sloan. So Pittsboro, Indiana, take a bow. But the headline in this World Championships and the women's all-around, the United States goes gold and silver, and Japan with a breakthrough bronze.
43 years since that's ever happened.
Up next, we'll see what it means for Bridget Sloan to win the gold medal in London, and it'll be our wrap-up from these World Championships and the Women's All-Around Final. The 2009 World Gymnastics Championships from London, England are being brought to you by Bud Light. Not too heavy, not too light. It's just right. And by McDonald's. Back at the O2 Arena in London, Al Trawick, Tim Daggett, and Elfie Schlegel. And it's Rebecca Bross in the front of the line, but in actuality, it's going to be Bridget Sloan's gold medal, with Bross taking the silver after what happened on the final move of the dismount of floor exercise for Rebecca Bross. Guys, what could she possibly be thinking?
She's thinking that I may have blown the chance of a lifetime, but, you know, 4 years earlier in 2005, you know who came in second place? Nastia Lukin.
Ladies and gentlemen, the presentation party and the gymnasts. The 2009 FIG Artistic Gymnastics World Championships for the Women's All-Around Final. Third place and winner of the bronze medal from Japan, Koko Tsurumi.
And this is huge.
Beautiful
gymnast. Japan gymnastics, she did a great job standing to her left. However, Lauren Mitchell, who is a quarter of a tenth
from the USA,
behind.
Rebecca Bross.
And no matter how you slice it, this is very bittersweet for this young lady. It was
first place,
just about
2009
in her hands.
All-around world champion from the USA, Bridget Sloan.
Bridget said when she told her teachers that she'd be missing 3 weeks of school, their eyes got really big. They'll all be boasting that they teach Bridget Sloan, world champion.
And props to her, I'll tell you, you know, Rebecca had the shot, but Bridget did the job all day long.
In fourth place from Australia, Lauren Mitchell. In fifth place from France.
Lauren Mitchell in that just awful fourth place.
China.
This is exactly where the gymnasts are going to stand in the Olympics in 2012. And you just wonder, because of the way things work, time and calendars and the juniors that are waiting, who's going to be standing here then?
Yeah, if you look at history, not a lot of them.
Now the presentation of medals. Just another great international experience for USA Gymnastics. They've been on a roll in this new century. And Bridget Sloan gets set. This is the kind of stuff you see on TV when you're
from Japan, Koko Tsurumi,
wondering whether something like this is possible for you, and then all of a sudden the anthem is playing and you're the one who created it. Oh my goodness.
1-2 here. USA was 1-2 in Beijing, China, with Nastia Lukin winning and Sean Johnson getting the silver.
This was their plan all along. I don't think anybody should be too surprised to see the Americans in the first and second spot.
Yeah, they've really dominated. It's remarkable.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please stand for the national anthem of the USA.
Thank you.
few years, we ask the question, who's the one? Who's the next one in women's gymnastics? And right now, the one is Bridget Sloan in American gymnastics. She is the national champion. She is the world champion. But she is going to be tested beyond anything she's had to overcome to this point. And that is what she's going to have to go through to make it to the Olympic Games in 2012.
March them from the floor. Make sure he's getting the papers the next day.
Got to get that photo shot also. This is one that Bridget is going to want to hold on to.
Well, her Beijing medal she takes to all kinds of school activities. She says she likes for the kids to actually touch it and to see it. I wonder if she'll do the same with this gold medal.
And it's good to see Rebecca Bras be able to smile here. That one might not be as sincere at this point.
But she could definitely be one of the ones back in 2012, of course.
And, no question.
And hopefully for her, a reminder of what not to do.
Such an experience for all of these athletes, though. You know, a bunch of years out from the Olympics to have an opportunity to compete in the same arena.
Look at the separation between the bronze and fourth place, 0.025. So, Bridget Sloan, congratulations. You are the world champion of the all-around.
You know, I was very excited. I was very thrilled to be out there, and I just wanted to make today, you know, no regrets and go out there. As I was doing my floor routine, I knew, you know, this is one of my stronger events, so I knew I had to just make it my best event. Congratulations, and good luck in the event finals.
Thank you.
So, Bridget Sloan of Pittsboro, Indiana, representing the United States, comes to the site of the 2012 Olympic Games and does the best that she absolutely could have done, winning the World Championship all-around gold medal. Elfie, your thoughts?
Well, I remember back at the National Championships in Dallas talking to her about the World Championships and perhaps the opportunity for her to win an all-around gold medal. And I remember Bridget, as she always does with her big eyes, she said, you know, it's possible. That's what I'm gunning for.
And the amazing thing is that she was on that team in 2008 that got the silver medal. And she was really the only athlete on that team that never stopped training. She said at different points she lacked a lot of motivation, but turned it around. And, you know, not a bad thing to join that list, I'll tell you.
She is with Mary Lou Retton, Kim Smeskel, Shannon Miller, Carly Patterson, Sean Johnson, and Nastia Lukin. But it's Chelsea Memel I'm thinking of, Tim and Elfie, because she won the World Championship, which is exactly where this one is on the Olympic calendar, the year after and 3 years before.
That's right, and there is a lot of reshuffling that's going to happen. You see the junior gymnasts coming up to the senior level. They're not age eligible yet. Chelsea, yes, she did hold on till 2008, but it was more of a supporting role than being the lead star.
And for Bridget Sloan, I mean, Bridget was the youngest, one of the younger members on the Olympic team in 2008, and she knew she wasn't finished. She was not done. Certainly, a world championship in the all-around is going to inspire Bridget, perhaps, to go the distance to 2012, but she's not committing yet.
Yeah, she hasn't committed. Bridget has not.
So it's always the test of any great athlete who dares to be great. Can you somehow find a way to forget what feels like the unforgettable?
No, there's absolutely no way she will ever forget that. She might forgive herself at some point, but not forget.
Hopefully there will be some peace in Rebecca Bras as she looks at that silver medal years in the future. But this was Bridget Sloan's chance to come to London, England, and be there on the top of the podium all by herself. That's going to do it at the O2 Arena. For Tim Daggett and Elfie Schlegel, I'm Al Troutwig. We'll see you tomorrow for the event finals of the World Championships at 2 Eastern Time.
And we have one sad postscript to report to you from the World Championships. Russian gymnast Yuri Razanov was killed in a car accident on Tuesday, just 5 days after winning a bronze medal in the all-around. Razanov was driving to his home in Vladimir, Russia, about 125 miles east of Moscow, when his car collided head-on with another vehicle. He died on the scene. Razanov was 22 years old.